Hey guys, and welcome back to more Fire Emblem Echoes, the post-game edition. So after you beat the game, you're supposed to go back to Sophia Harbor. And you're supposed to escort this guy back to Arcanea. I'm already smelling a lot of boat maps if we're gonna have to sail. Oh wait, I probably need to just leave the harbor. Yep. Well, hello there! That was right. We're gonna have to do some boat maps. Say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Alright. One thing you guys are probably gonna notice is that my units are different. That's because I'm actually using a save file that I did on a second playthrough on my stream. So some units are different because I tried some stuff. Some units remain the same. And obviously since it's post-game, some units are... Look at these two. Alright. Speed. Ooh, look at this guy. 40 damage with an axe. Alright. Something tells me Python is gonna come in handy here. Alright.
Fine, twist my arm.
Oh, I can't shoot this guy. Damn it. Okay, who has the highest defense? Alm has the highest defense. Yeah. So you're gonna tank this for me, Alm.
Leave this to me.
Yes, allow me.
Watch me go. Let us proceed.
Allow me.
Just leave it to me. I'll do my best.
Wow, not great with 53%. Oh well. Can you hit him, Dalton? Oh, you do that again. Wow. Thanks for no crits, Python. Appreciate it.
My apologies. No! All thanks to the mother. We're lucky to have you.
Not quite. That will do it though.
There we go.
But yeah, one thing to note is that you do keep the falchion for the post-game. So, that's pretty nice. Although, I will probably switch to the Omega Sword eventually. Just because that sword is a bit better.
You're just full of surprises.
Alright, I think we're gonna send Clive over here. Maybe Matilda.
Make your peace.
Yeah, on my second playthrough I tried to make Clive a lot better, but he wasn't working out as a cavalier, so I just used a pitchfork, whatever, to make him a villager and then
now it's my turn.
Go get him through the mercenary line. And as you can see, he's actually not bad. He's still pretty slow, but his attack and defense are pretty good. And the speed is not awful either. Yeah, that Devil Axe guy hurts.
Allow me. I'll not be trifled with.
Good job, Clive. Never thought I would say that in a in the actual playthrough. Dude, Clive is going in. He's making up for being trashed through the whole first playthrough. Funny enough, on the final map, he was the one that got the kill on Jedha too, so... definitely putting in work. Nice.
Is it okay for the goddess to pick favorites like this?
You know, surprisingly, my Deltia is not like amazing like it was on the first playthrough. She's kind of close to how Mei was. But she's not bad either. Monato Pasta!
Success!
Can't believe I never said that during the playthrough either.
You have skill, I see.
Alright, Clive, you can finish this game.
Submit or be struck down!
Then they can take care of the Gold Knights. Oh, they do speed you though. By the way, a lot of people were wondering why I never had killer bows on my playthrough.
You're unstoppable.
Well, the main reason was because I actually didn't know how to make them. And before I knew, I already finished the playthrough, so... but yeah, you just forge them from silver bows. And if you want to get them as soon as possible, you can forge silver bows from steel bows, so... but yeah, now I can see why a lot of people were recommending me the killer bow, because it's disgusting how good it is. Let's give Tatiana a kill.
I did it!
Another feather in our caps.
Clive, the MVP of this map. Pretty good. Let's see if we can get to the dungeon on just one video. Get all these sea battles out of the way. Shouldn't be too bad, right? I know the people have said that the tower itself is kind of a pain in the ass, so... Why are there terrors still alive with Doom and Dogon? The hell? Alright, well, whatever. Alright. Well, I kinda have an idea of how to do this. I need to give Celtica the mage ring, though. And we're gonna send Meissen and Clive this way. Alright, let's go. The mage ring is so damn good against pretty much all these terrors.
Let us proceed.
Can't quite make it there, but this, yeah. Also, I'm kinda disappointed on the Celica in this playthrough too, because she ended up being a lot slower than the other one I had. Alm is not as strong either. But, oh well, they still got the job done, so not a huge loss.
Fine, twist my arm.
Fine, twist my arm. Oh, damn. Oh. Oh, what? The hell was that, Biden? That's how it's done, Python. Now let's see if we can actually rescue him back. So nice to have Faye with actual being actually useful. Unfortunately, the Falcon Knight Faye did not work out as I wanted it to. So. Look at that. Clive actually tanking magic. Never thought that would see the day, right? Although he can't really tank them that well, but... Oh! Nice and juicy 3 damage. I mean, I might crit, so... There we go.
Sorry, not your preferred outcome? Consider this a mercy.
We'll level up Matilda. Then again, that's pretty much expected out of her. Alright, let's kill the Mogul. And Clive and Meisen should be able to finish these guys.
No mercy. Be at peace. Age comes with its own insights, it would seem.
But yeah, I also wanted to start using Meisen because even though he's a late game Jagen, pretty much, I kind of wanted to choke him in action a bit. Because otherwise he would be on the bench anyway. In fact, I believe on the first playthrough, the moment he joined, I just benched him immediately. So. Also, Clive did not greet the guy, so go fix the mistake.
This is my strength. I feel
nice.
See now who you trifle with?
Attack and speed is always good on Alm. Like I always said. I can see the land now, so we're getting close. Let's see, what do we have here? A brethren. What's this water breath? A wall of water that bypasses defenses. Really? This egg has 24 speed. Oh, these guys are back. Okay. Wait, these guys don't count as terrors. No, no, they are dragons. So Seraphim shouldn't be effective. Yeah. They are flyers though, right? No, they're not flyers either. Alright, well. Regardless. Man, they hurt. These guys hurt. All right.
Let us proceed.
There is one down.
You've improved.
Just leave it to me. Leave this to me.
Yeah. These guys are pretty nasty. Okay, so I think what I will have to do is warp on to kill this one.
Alright, let's go.
Dragon feeling. I think I needed that for a sub quest, didn't I? Well, I'll have to check it out later.
Watch me go.
Allow me. Allow me.
Who does more damage? Meisen does more damage. Well, hopefully he gets a crit too. Age before beauty. Alright, that's good. So now what I can do is rescue Deltia.
Fine, twist my arm.
Oh, Python can actually kill it. Alright. Just in case, though. I mean, I know Python can probably overkill the Muggles since those are flyers. But yeah, just wanted to see. Man, Sig is actually getting a lot of crits with the Gradivus.
That's the way.
Really, the only one that can outspeed those Gargoyles is Alm. Oh, that's another thing. I haven't used a lot of my stat boosters in this playthrough either, so I might have to see who to give those to. Alright, I think what I will do is get Alm back here. Have him attract these guys. Python can take care of this guy.
Open wide. Nighty-night. You could go far.
I guess we can take this time to heal everybody. Does 45? Yeah, 45 reach everybody.
You're making me want to work harder.
It seems like these terrors have the same stats they had in the Duma dungeon. Whoa, the hell? Reinforcements? In Echoes? Oh, these are actual Falconets. Well, too bad none of us are terrors. Alright then. They're actually kinda weak. They're not too strong. Oh. I didn't mean to do that. Oh well, they do one damage to Seek anyway. What happens if I do that with the Falchion gun? Ah, that's a one shot. Nice. Oh. Well. Something tells me that I should have brought two of my bow guys, but oh well. This still works. Doesn't really matter too much.
I still have much to learn.
I think I will keep. No, I should keep it. Otherwise, these two are gonna. Oh, they're both gonna target Python anyway. Silica, you're gonna get hit by a Silver Lance. Not very recommended. Well, at least he can retaliate with the Gradivus, so that's nice. Although, that 7% crit is kinda worrying. I mean, it's 9 damage, but if they all do it, it's gonna add up pretty fast.
So sorry about this. Congrats, you came in second.
Oh. Sick is getting kinda weak. Ah, shit, more reinforcements?
I'm ready.
Oh. So, yeah, let's kill this guy.
Hello and goodbye.
He did it again.
Matilda can take care of this guy. Then Sick can back off. And now Silica can finish this guy. And I guess I can rescue Deltia so she can kill this one. Okay, that works well. That works pretty well, if I do say so myself. Get that fortify.
You're making me want to work harder.
I guess might as well start baiting those guys out. They both have speed, Meissen and Clive though. Oh shit. This is looking like an awakening map right now with all these reinforcements. Good thing this game doesn't have ambush spawns though. Alright.
Excellent. Yes, allow me.
That's a good level up, Sodika. She's gonna get hit by two guys though. Alright, that should be good. Unfortunately, I can't really hit them from all the way here, so just gonna have to wait.
It's over.
Oh. That's the kind of low percent crit that I was expecting with the Pegasus. Just had to wait an extra turn though. Oh! Didn't notice Fly was in range. These guys don't hurt too much though. Oh, what? Oh, do they have that attack that seals magic? They do. Well then. These guys are not terrors right now. They're flyers. No, they're great terrors, never mind. Alright, let's see, how do we go about this? Sick. You kill this guy.
Fate is cruel.
Okay. Alm can kill. Who can Alm kill actually? I guess Clive can kill this guy. Maybe. If I get a crit. No crit.
dedicate this victory to you.
All right, so I can shoot this guy with Python. And then... But, let's see, where do I have to put myself to shoot? Here. Alright, if I give the killer bow to Alm, can he shoot from here? 1, 2, 3? Yeah, he should be able to. Alright. That sounds good then. Well, I take advantage of Alm be able to use bows, so.
You're unstoppable today.
Oh hell, I don't even need to trade his bow either. I can just straight up take it from the inventory. Since I do have two.
Alright. I'll never yield.
Less work for me.
Alright, Selica can kill this gargoyle.
Help this! I fight to protect what is dear.
And then Deltia can finish this guy off. Can she? Oh shit, she can't. Gonna need some help from Meisen.
No mercy. You lack experience.
Oh, I can't believe this dragon is actually fast enough to not get doubled. This never happened on the playthrough, but it's kind of funny to see a no-stat level up. This is very common with Meisen because he maxes his HP really fast, and then since his other growths are awful, he doesn't get any other stats.
That was a fine victory.
Well, at least you got to see a no-stat level up during this whole thing. Alright, and that's all the chief battles. Welcome to Furia. Oh, thanks for the gold marks. Thaves. Thaves, Tavis. I don't know how you pronounce that. But yeah, that's supposed to be like the post-game dungeon. Which I heard is pretty long, so... Hey, hey, hey. That's racist, man. You get another dragon, feel it here. Just in case you, for some reason, didn't get it from the other dragon. Got a smithy. I can tell this is the point where they run out of budget for the voice acting. All of these NPCs aren't really... don't have voices. Multisport. Thanks for telling me none of them, Alm. Alright. What else do we have? Mila Idol. Oh. Okay. Well, I guess I might as well show this. So, When you reach level 10 with the Dread Fighters, they actually get the option to revert back to villagers. This is what people call the Dread Fighter loop. And it's pretty good if you want to like max out stats or be able to level up infinitely. Just keep going into the mercenary line. Unfortunately, you can only do it with male characters because women don't get mercenary, so rest in peace, females. Although for that you have the pitchfork, so you can at least do that with the limited pitchfork as you have. I think I might actually do it with Matilda because I do want her to not max out, but just get better stats. Since only 10 level 10 levels to go, she's definitely not gonna max out anything. But yeah, actually, I might as well show it. Sick Live in all his genericness as a villager.
As Mila wills it, so shall it be.
This is the strongest villager we have seen in this playthrough. So far, anyway. I've heard Tavis has some very nasty villager-like type of enemies. So that's gonna be fun to see. But yeah, so Clive now is a villager and he actually levels up really fast as a villager too. Until he gets to the level 10s around there. But anyway, think that's everything here. See if there is anything on the smithy. Oh, there is a drinking water. Alright, I'm not gonna forge yet because I actually want to. So, this is where the post-game dungeon is. I'm actually gonna prepare myself a bit before tackling this place because I've heard stories, and I want to be as prepared as I can. At least with forging and stuff like that, since I just got some money, so might as well. But yeah, I'll see you guys next time. I'm kinda glad we kinda got all the boat maps on the same video without having to grind for it. So, that was good. Alright, guys. Thanks for. I can't talk today. Thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you on the next one.